Hi, everyone, and thank you for taking the time to join our session today, where we're going to be talking about architecting secure enterprise-ready solutions for the cloud with Azure and MySQL. My name is Andrea Lam, and I'm a senior program manager on the Azure Database for MySQL and MariaDB team, and I'm very excited to be here today to talk to you about this topic. In this session, we're going to be covering a few key components. The first, we're going to be talking about the microservices architecture. Next, I'm going to introduce Azure Database for MySQL and actually give you a sneak peek into the Azure Database for MySQL architecture. Next, we're going to talk about securing your data. And finally, we'll talk about some of the new innovations our team has been working on. First, let's go over the microservices architecture. In microservices, we typically see customers splitting out the stateless front end from the stateful back end. And this architecture here that I'm showing you on the slide is actually based on one of our real-life customers. And they use this to support millions of banking transactions daily. And we see them using microservices running in different containers, with Docker being their most preferred technology. First, they want to consider how to manage a large scale of microservices. And they use this and manage this using some form of container orchestration in Kubernetes. In Azure, we offer the Azure Kubernetes service, which can be used to manage your microservices. From there, they want to ensure that all of this gets encapsulated in a network boundary. And this ensures that you're protecting and having some form of network isolation and ensuring that you are able to monitor who has access to the application and how to protect your data. So now that we talked about the stateless front end of things, let's talk about the stateful component of the application. This is where PaaS offerings typically come into play and also provide some type of open source technology. And this can be used as a persistent data store for your application. And on top of that, in Azure, we also have a ton of really great analytic tools that can be used to integrate with your data storage, allowing you to perform additional analysis and help to make data-driven decisions. So what's the advantage of the setup? Well, when you're splitting your application across different services and modules, this allows you to scale each component individually and allows you to scale to grow your demands for your particular workload. Another benefit of using a persistent PaaS layer is to help alleviate some of the manageability headaches that may come with it. And this includes the ability to perform automatic backups and maintain high availability, to name a few. And finally, when you're using a PaaS layer and building on top of the security tools that are available in the cloud provider, you can take advantage of some of the key innovations that we here in Azure are helping to provide our customers with. So when you think about the stateful PaaS layer, what are some of the requirements that you should be considering? Well, first, you want to think about something that is truly a fully managed solution. And this includes the ability to provide automatic backups, built-in high availability, resiliency, and disaster recovery tools. Another thing to think about is how to scale on demand when you need to, and this ensures that your application is able to meet the workload's needs. And this can be done using a couple clicks of a button in the Azure portal or using some simple Azure CLI commands. From there, you might want to also consider the different security tooling and compliance certifications that a particular service has. And so many of you may be thinking about PCI, HIPAA, or FedRAMP, to name a few. And then when it comes to developers, we really want to make sure that many of these services are integrated with each other. This ensures that you as a developer don't really have to think about how to do this additional integration yourself. And then we also want to make sure that many of the tools and frameworks that you're already used to using can all be used directly against these PaaS services. Lastly, cost efficiency is something that's top of mind. And this includes things like stopping your server over the weekend and then starting it again when you're back in the office on a weekday. And then also things really around low prices in terms of providing you with dev test queues, to name a few. So now that we've talked about some of the requirements of a PaaS layer, I now wanted to introduce Azure Database for MySQL, which can help with meeting some of these requirements in terms of data storage needs. Azure Database for MySQL is a fully managed database service here in Azure, and it's integrated with many of the different Azure services we have available. One of the great things about this MySQL service is we're actually running the community edition of MySQL. So many of the tools and frameworks that you as a developer are already used to using against MySQL can all just be re-leveraged. Secondly, the MySQL service comes with a built-in high availability SLA, and this is money-backed with 99.99% high availability. And this also ensures that you have the lowest total cost of ownership because you don't actually need to stand up a second server in order to get that high availability. We offer it for every individual server that you provision. And as I mentioned earlier, Azure also also keeps in mind that security is one of the top priorities for you and for us. And to help with that, we offer things like advanced threat protection, which we'll talk about a little bit later, which provides you with some of the latest innovations that we've been working on in the security space. Next, there are also some great built-in intelligence features that we have, and this includes the intelligent performance suite of features that we have that allows you to get more insight into some of the query performance that you have on your server and offers recommendations on how we can potentially improve your performance on the server as well. And like I mentioned, integration with other Azure services is also super important as it also helps to simplify your life as a developer and integrate with other things like the Azure App Service or Power BI. Next, I wanted to give you a sneak peek into the Azure Database for MySQL architecture and give you a little bit of a better idea of how we can actually offer you that 99.99% high availability SLA. So as you can see here on the right side of your screen, we have an MySQL application that's trying to connect to an Azure Database for MySQL server. First, the connection is routed through our gateway, and the gateway sits in front of all the backend nodes in our service. From there, the connection goes to the gateway, and then the gateway interprets the connection string and is able to then route that connection to the appropriate MySQL server running on the backend. That MySQL server is also connected to Azure Storage. Azure Storage is what we use to host all the data files and backup files for your particular server. And we also have the Azure Database Management Service, which is used to detect any issues that may be running in your server and also helps with facilitating any failovers. Next, I wanted to highlight what happens when something goes wrong with one of the data files. So when we detect that, what we then do is then switch over your MySQL to point to a different data file that's hosted within Azure Storage. As I mentioned earlier, Azure Storage keeps three copies of those data files on your behalf. Next, I wanted to highlight what happens if something might go wrong with the MySQL server itself. The Azure Database Management Service can detect unhealthy nodes. And from there, it will stand up a new MySQL server. And then the gateway gets rerouted and points now to the updated server hosted in the backend for your MySQL server. And from there, we definitely recommend having retry logic built into your application to reconnect. And then once the server is back up and running, it will continue that connection. So now that you've learned more about microservices and Azure Database for MySQL, I wanted to show you how all that comes together. And to do that, I wanted to use Magento as an example. Now, Magento is an open source e-commerce solution developed in PHP, and it actually uses MySQL to store its application data. And I'm going to use Magento to now highlight some of the traditional security gaps that might come with hosting your application and database in the cloud. The first is really around having your services and traffic be exposed to the public internet, leaving them vulnerable potentially for security breaches. The second is around how you store your data, both at rest on your database as well as in storage drives. And these can be attractive targets for attackers and can potentially be used for data exploitation. The third is really around granting users the correct access to the different resources that you may have in a timely manner. And the fourth is really around detecting unusual and harmful attempts against your data. So now that we've talked about some traditional security gaps, I now wanted to highlight how Azure Database for MySQL's innovations can help protect against some of those gaps. The first is really around network isolation. And to do that, we provide varying levels of isolation for different networking solutions. and this includes Azure Private Link as well as virtual networks. Secondly, when it comes to data security, we do provide data protection both at rest and in motion, and this is done through SSL and TLS enforcement, data encryption at rest using custom managed keys, which allows you to rotate your keys as you need, infrastructure double encryption, which is in preview, which gives you an additional layer of data encryption. The third was around access control, and to do that, we offer Azure AD authentication, which uses a token-based authentication method to connect to your Azure database for MySQL server. And the fourth is around preventing and monitoring unusual activities. And for that, we have the Advanced Threat Protection Preview, which can be used to monitor and alert you for any unusual activities that may be happening on your server. And we also offer audit logging, which allows you to track database activity and provide that as evidence for different compliance certificates that you may have. Next, I wanted to highlight some key points for you to take away from this session. The first is really around Microsoft's commitment to making Azure the most secure cloud for all of your data and application needs. Secondly, Azure Database for MySQL offers a bunch of really great enterprise security controls, which are aligned with industry security controls to help you as a customer quickly, efficiently, and effectively meet applicable security and compliance requirements. Third, security and compliance is a shared responsibility in the cloud. And for that, I definitely recommend that you check out the shared responsibility model, which I'll link for you at the end of this session. Next, I wanted to talk to you about some of the great new innovations our team has been working on. Recently, we introduced the preview of Flexible Server, which is a new deployment option for Azure Database for MySQL. It offers three big key components. The first is really around maximum control for your databases. And this offers you the ability to actually deploy your server within a virtual network by delegating a subnet to your MySQL Flexible Servers. We also offer server parameters for giving you more fine-grained tuning for your particular workload's needs. And we've also introduced custom maintenance windows, which allows you to tell us when you can actually receive maintenance against your servers. The second is really around building resilient applications. And for that, we offer zone redundant high availability, allowing you to stand up a hot standby in another availability zone. And this helps with preventing zero data loss when we perform fast failovers, and also allows you to co-locate your application to a availability zone to help with minimizing network latency. And the third is really around a simplified developer experience. And for that, we went through every Azure portal screen that we have, as well as every Azure CLI command that we have available for Flexible Server, and tried to simplify those as easily and as best as possible. We also offer MySQL using the same community edition that we have in our existing service. And we've also introduced great new features around cost optimization. This includes stop-start and burstable. Stop-start allows you to stop your server and then restart it when you need to, so you can stop that over the weekend and restart it when you're back in the office on Monday. And also offer burstable as a new compute tier. And burstable is really great for some workloads that don't need that CPU consistently throughout the day, and allows you to bank up credits and then with that spike up to 100% CPU. Flexible Server is a result of much of the feedback that we've received from our existing customers. So I really thank you for the feedback that you've provided us, and definitely recommend that you go check out this new preview today. Last, I wanted to leave you with some great resources to get started. So definitely check out our MySQL documentation to look through some of our quick starts, learn more about the features that we have available, and also recommend that you check out the cloud shared responsibility model that we discussed earlier to learn more about the different responsibilities that you as a customer have, as well as us as a cloud provider. And I also recommend checking out our Azure Database for MySQL blog to learn more about the Flexible Server announcements that we recently made. And if you have any questions about Flexible Server or anything that we discussed here today in this session, please feel free to reach out to us at askazuredb@service.microsoft.com. And also follow us on Twitter to keep up to date on the latest announcements for features that we're working on. And with that, I wanted to thank everybody for taking the time to watch this session today. I hope everybody is staying happy and healthy.